Hey guys, my name is Brent Nicole. Welcome back to my channel, and today let's talk about Jennifer L. Armentrout. So if you guys don't know, if you haven't been following any of my reading vlogs in the past like year, Jennifer L. Armentrout has become one of my all-time favorite authors. So here are all the current books that I have read. I have not read Obsession just yet. I have started it, but I haven't finished it yet. And I have read From Blood and Ash, which just recently came out the beginning of this year, but I do not own a physical copy. I read it on ebook. I do need to get myself a physical copy because I want to own all the books of hers that I end up loving. So this video is going to be kind of recommendation on how I feel like from what I have currently read, how you should read her series if you guys are just starting out with her. So let's just go ahead and get into it. So starting with her White Hot Kiss series, which White Hot Kiss is the first one. Then we have Stone Cold Touch and Every Last Breath. In this trilogy, we follow a girl named Layla who is very much wanting to be just a regular girl. She is half gargoyle, and the gargoyles in this book are like wardens, and they try to protect people from the demons. They go out at nighttime and they kill demons, but she is half gargoyle and half demon. That is all on the back of this book, the synopsis. But unfortunately, because Layla is half demon, anyone that she kisses, she can actually steal people's souls. She has this ability. She can see people's auras and like see their souls, and she sees the souls in different colors. And all she really wants to do is be a teenage girl and go out with this cute guy that she loves and she's grown up with. And things take a turn for worse before it always gets better. And I highly recommend the series. And the reason why I'm starting off with White Hot Kiss, because it is probably my ultimate favorite series of Jennifer L. Armentrout overall. And but yeah, I just highly recommend this. It has a lot of intrigue. The world building is great. The warden aspect and the gargoyle aspect of this is awesome. The demons in this were very detailed. I can see every single thing every time JLA was describing her demons in her world. It just was unbelievably amazing. So carrying on, we do have Storm of Fury and Rage and Ruin. That Rage and Ruin just came out last week when I'm filming this, so probably 2 weeks when you guys are seeing this. The first one being Storm of Fury, second one being Rage and Ruin. This is a carry-on series from White Hot Kiss that you guys just saw, but it follows a different set of main characters. And we follow Trinity, who everybody thinks is human, and she's actually growing up with the wardens in a different area from where White Hot Kiss takes place. And we actually get to meet up with Zane from the White Hot Kiss series, and we actually get to meet up with Layla and Roth in this series. So we finally get to see like a continuance of from the White Hot Kiss series, but following a different main character, Trinity, and what she's going through. And everybody thinks she's human and the different things that she can do. It's really neat. I also think that on the back of the synopsis it says that she can see ghosts, and that's really a different trait that you don't really see a lot in these books. So again, I highly recommend, after you're reading White Hot Kiss series, you need to read Storm Fury and Rage and Ruin. We will be getting a third one hopefully sooner than later. It'll probably be 2021 before we get it. Hey guys, actually when I was editing this video, Jennifer L. Armentrout announced that the next book in the series is going to be called Grace and Glory, and it comes out summer of 2021. Now, this is the cover that we have for as of right now. This is not going to be the end cover, is what my understanding. They just kind of wanted to give us a name. So, anyways, this is going to be a third book in that series. Let's get back to the video.
But I really think if you read these before you read these, you're not going to understand the backstory of Layla, Roth, and Zane before you read into Trinity's world. So the next ones we have are Obsidian, Onyx, Opal, Origin, and Obsidian. I don't know why I can't say that word. It's just not in my vocabulary apparently. But this trilogy is called the Lux series, and we follow a girl who's just moved into West Virginia for her senior year, and her neighbors are kind of weird, and come to find out her neighbors are aliens and they're called the Luxons. And following this girl, I'm trying to understand what aliens are and come to terms that her neighbors are aliens and what the Luxons are going through from their world and the reason why they had to leave their world to come here. And now a great story. It's a lot of like hate to love romance and a great world building, amazing fantasy telling, and a great magic system. So after you guys get done with the Lux series, those 5 books, I do recommend going on to The Darkest Star and The Burning Shadow. These books take place in the same universe as the Lux series, but it's been a few, I don't really know how many years, but we do understand that the Earth has realized there are aliens and what we're dealing with that. So we follow Eva and her story and what's going on with her and how she's dealing with the fact that there are Lux in the world. And another great love story. Pretty much Jennifer L. Armentrout knows how to write a great romance. Very antsy, so you really want to keep coming back for more and more and more. And all her books have that. And I highly recommend, if you want to keep carrying on Luxem World, that you need to carry on with The Darkest Star and The Burning Shadow.
Okay guys, here's the third book in this trilogy. It's called The Brightest Night. It's coming out in October of 2020, so this year. And unfortunately, as of right now, the publisher has decided to go with this look for the new covers. And I personally do not like this new cover, but it is what it is. And I guess I will be getting my other two in the new covers because I want my whole series to match, and I don't know, I'm a little disappointed with the publication for changing this, but it is what it is. But yeah, I can't wait for this book to come out at the end of this year.
Then we're gonna go into her Half-Blood series, and oh guys, if you like angels, purebloods, half-bloods, a good romance situation, all of these books are about teenage people, of course, but this is about a half-blood having a really hard crush on a pureblood, and that is not something that you should do. Half-bloods are actually supposed to go to this training school and graduate and become sentinels, and the sentinels actually keep the pureblood safe, but there are a lot of tricks and turns that happen on the way with her becoming essential and in the school. And is she going to eventually have a relationship with a pureblood and go against all these other people who don't want it to happen? And a lot of other things happen. There is a good love triangle in this book also that I think everybody should read. I love a good, well-written love triangle. I know that's kind of taboo here on BookTube, but I'm one of those people who actually loves good love triangles. So first we have Half-Blood, then we have Dignity, Sentinel, Pure, and Apollon. And these book covers, guys, when they're on my bookshelves, they're so beautiful together. I just like looking over at my Jennifer L. Armentrout shelf and seeing all the colorful books right here. Unfortunately, she hasn't written another series into this world. I really think I personally want another book set in this world because that'd be interesting. Maybe a different person at the same time that all this is going on. I don't know. I don't know how she would do it, but it would be really cool if we got some more in-depth details about this world that she has built so much into. So now we have Wicked, Torn, and Brave, and this is an amazing romance that is set in the French Quarter in New Orleans. And guys, like I've said in the past, all these other books, Jennifer L. Armentrout knows to write a good atmosphere, and I've had the chance to go to New Orleans, and I've been in the French Quarter, and it really shows you she does a lot of detail, whether she went there or she did a lot of background work, because every single detail she talked about when the girl was walking down the French Quarter and where she was going, I was there and I could actually see it in my mind. And I really like that aspect that I could really relate to this person because I've been to this location before, I've been there. But we follow Ivy Morgan, and she is in this order, and she's been in order for a while. Her family was brutally murdered about 4 or 5 years ago when this book starts. And she goes around killing all these creatures, kind of like demons. And the Order is this organization of people who are brought up to kill these types of things. There are fae in this. That was a really interesting aspect of that also. And the glamours on some of these creatures that were putting off and what they really looked like and what they didn't. That was cool. The love interest in this book is a slow burn till the end. I would kind of say slow burn, kind of not. The first book I would kind of say slow burn, but once you get into the other ones, it really becomes more real to everybody. But by the first one, you kind of understand what's going on with that romance. But again, Jennifer L. Armentrout knows to write a good romance, and highly recommend her Wicked series. Even though I have not read obsession yet. This is an Arion novel he's to die for. This is like a adult romance that is set in the Lux series. I really don't understand what's going on just yet or how this is going to go about. All I know is set in like the Lux world because we have met some of the Luxons and some of the other stuff that's in that world. And yeah, so far it's been really neat.
I haven't really gotten that far into it, guys. So, like I said, I can't really tell you guys what's going on because I haven't read all of it yet.
Then last but not least of what I physically own, I'm trying to talk about this book without getting emotional because I...
The Problem with Forever. I forgot to say the title.
I love this book so much. So, we follow a girl who has been adopted by these people, and she was in a really bad home situation, and she was beaten by the people who was keeping her. So when she goes to this new school, after years of therapy with her adoptive parents and psychiatrist, she goes to a new school, and she runs into the guy that she used to live with when she was being taken care of, this foster family, and all these feelings of what she went through and what he went through in the foster system come up, and this has a really cute love story and really cute bonding over the fact that they both can recognize they've both been through this and where she's ended up and where he's ended up because of the situation. So it's a really good representation of what could eventually happen when kids are treated so badly in the foster care system. And I highly recommend everybody picking this up. It is a standalone book. It's not magic. It is a contemporary. But this was so good. It's a heartbreaking, loving. I cried in this book multiple times. And I do not cry in books, guys, at all. And I love this so much. So the next book that I have read by Jennifer L. Armentrout is From Blood and Ash. And this is about a maiden. And this is a girl that is chosen from birth to be this, like, symbol of good. And she's taken in by this Dutch and Duchess. And a lot of things go down. She also can't be seen. She is covered from head to toe in a veil and this long gown, flowing sleeves, so nobody really knows what she looks like. And at night she does kind of go off and do her own thing without being covered because nobody really knows what she looks like. She gets involved in detailed politics, and I really like the politics in this book, and the world building and the magic system was really neat. And I can't wait for the second book to come out. Hopefully there's a second book. As right now, when I looked, there wasn't one, but I really want to get to it soon. So Jennifer L. Armentrout has so many books out that I'm trying to make my way through every single one of them, and I will be keeping the ones that I like, and I won't be keeping the ones that I don't like. But as of right now, I've read 22 books, and I'm currently working on 23, and I need to get From Blood and Ash and put it on my physical shelf. I'm probably going to end up having to have like two shelves for her eventually one day. But yeah, guys, this was my recommendation video for how you should read Jennifer L. Armentrout and how much I love her writing and her character so much. She's become a favorite author of mine, no doubt. And I hope you guys like this video. Please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. And I look forward to seeing everybody soon in my next video. Bye!